This is a production of PBS 39.
The television networks feed us a steady diet of so-called reality-based shows, and many of us walk away less than satisfied. We hunger for more substance and meaning. Well, that's exactly what the producers and contributors of a play called The Giants of the Lehigh Valley have in store for us. It's part of a Black Heritage project that brings to light the oral histories of the Lehigh Valley's African-American community. Grover Silcox has more.
We were Pullman porters, settling in the valley to protect our families.
We came with a dream even before it was spoken.
The stories inspire, enlighten, and heal. They come from the old, the young, and those in between among the Lehigh Valley's African-American community.
He became one of the first African-American teachers in Easton.
Since 2001, community leaders such as Dr. Ethel Drayton Craig of Muhlenberg College have led the drive to collect oral histories as part of a Lehigh Valley Black Heritage Project.
We made home out of places to stay, boarding houses, places to let.
Making homes of the dream. But as dreams go, they faded in the morning.
Recently, Dr. Craig and her cohorts enlisted Bethlehem's Touchstone Theater Group to help gather more personal stories of the Black experience with the intention of transforming them into a play tentatively titled Giants of the Lehigh Valley.
Touchstone Theater is an ensemble-based professional theater company where we produce and present original works of theater, and we educate and build community through the tools of theater.
Touchstone called on some past collaborators to help with the project.
We enlisted a number of guest artists, people who we've worked with in the past, storyteller and performer Peggy Pettit, who gathers stories throughout her community in New York and creates original theater works. Issei Barnwell, one of the greatest composers and a cappella singers in the United States today. So we brought her in to help gather songs from the community. Then Linda Paris Bailey, who is the artistic director of Carpetbag Theater, one of the oldest African-American theater ensembles in the United States. And she has come on as the playwright to take these stories that we have gathered with Peggy Pettit, these songs with Issei Barnwell, and she's forming a script out of that.
Of course, the most essential collaborator is the community itself. People have come from Allentown, Bethlehem, and Easton areas to share their personal stories or to read the stories of others at specially held gatherings. They've also come to read first drafts of the script, which continues as a work in progress.
So we got the community involved, not only reading some of the parts, but hearing it and able to respond.
Many of the people who came to hear the reading were involved in contributing stories.
People have also contributed music that has impacted their lives. Issei Barnwell's collecting these contributions, arranging them, and working with singers and actors who hope to perform them.
We actually collected quite a long list of songs. It was amazing. And we sang together. At all of those sessions, we sang together. It was wonderful.
With many of the stories and songs collected, and the script nearing completion, Mark has started casting.
If you're called back tomorrow night, I want you to come back and write down any conflicts you have next to the day.
We're looking for young people. We're looking for older people, male, female. We're looking for multiple races in this cast. While it's an African-American story, it's a story about the whole Lehigh Valley.
Some who come to audition have stage experience, but many have little or none.
I've seen some professional actors who, you know, they're pretty slick, but it's their 100th performance and they're phoning it in. That genuineness, that authenticity is what we're really looking for. And you can't fake motivation and desire to really be a part of something. And we can see that when people walk in the door.
I was a little nervous at first, but, you know, once you sort of get up there and get comfortable, it's a little easier.
And I got comfortable, and I think I did well. I hope so. I hope I get whatever part there is.
While Mark conducts auditions at this particular session, Issei Barnwell works with those hoping for singing roles.
I will ask them to hold the melody while I sing the harmony just to see how stable they are. Sometimes I'll ask them to sing the harmony and I sing the melody.
Row, row.
I like the nervousness, you know. That's what I love about stage. You get out there, there's no cut, there's no background roll. It's just go.
Well, that's the kind of enthusiasm Mark's depending on to make this play a meaningful tribute to Black heritage and its contribution to the entire Lehigh Valley community.
We do want a lot of different voices represented. And I think what will make the difference is the motivation and passion of somebody who wants to be a part of this. That's really what's important, and that's what comes across.
For Tempo, I'm Grover Silcox reporting.